I was all lined up ready to go out and get a bronze medal, and the officials came in and basically told me to go, and Shevinska came in and she took the bronze medal. So it was a very disappointing start for me as a 17-year-old in my first Olympic final to have that happen to me. Hello. Yes, I just turned 17. It was quite a surprise to me to go across to Mexico. I don't think at that stage there was a lot of pressure because I didn't quite understand what I was going to. I just knew I was going across to the Olympic Games, which meant not that much to me, to run some races. So to go over there, to arrive in a country that had a lot more poverty than the country I came from, and to spend some time there before the game started was actually quite difficult for me.
Yes, speaking, yeah. When we landed in Mexico, we discovered we could not run one lap of the track without stopping. We were so puffed out. The altitude was up around 2,000 metres, and that made it very hard to actually run with the same oxygen intake. So we did suffer a little bit, and it took a few weeks for us to acclimatise to that. It was a very warm day. We had a lot of rain during the semi-final and the time after that, so we were all very wet. I remember warming up for that final, being very nervous.
I can remember Chi Ching was in the lane next to me. She had both of her quads from sort of her groin down to her knees very heavily strapped. And I found that really strange. Barbara Farrell, on the other hand, was a shorter black woman, still very relaxed, had a beautiful running style. She was like silk to watch. Outside of that, I remember Shevinska, because she was the other side of the track to me. She was very, very tall and lanky, and I couldn't believe someone so tall could run fast. Diverge was shorter than me and a bit chunkier. And of course she was the queen of sprinting in Australia until I came along. And Wyomia Tyus was a couple of lanes to the right of me.
This is Dwight.
My memories of that Olympic Games are so vivid from being 14 years old and watching every moment of it that those are my heroes. And Wyomia was part of that. And again, she was just a natural-born sprinter. You know, very, very lean forward. As an athlete, the psychological strength that she would bring to a race, she would just intimidate you out of any chance of beating her. And she really wasn't like that. She was actually kind of shy. But on the track, she was an assassin. And the Titan Up is famous. She's standing there, and everybody else looks facing. You're very nervous at the beginning of a final at the Olympics. Of course, you're nervous on some level. Good nervous, maybe bad nervous. But and Tyus maybe even was nervous too. But the way she chose to manifest it was that she got there by her starting blocks and she started doing the Titan Up. And what that did was it loosened her up and tightened everybody else up. And that's why she did it, because it was just another technique, it was another thing that she thought of that she had never done, that they had never seen, that was going to take everybody else out of their game.
I was right up there with them. Barbara Farrell and Wyomia Tyus were to my right, and Xi Qing was on my left. And I can just remember that it was very tight. 100 metres is very tight. You know, there's a lot of straining, and it's very hard to stay relaxed. But I was there to win it. And so when Tyus sort of led the pack out, I was trying to stay with her.
Just one of those times when the race takes forever, sort of thing, and you're trying so hard to go faster, and it just wouldn't come. I couldn't make myself run any faster at that stage. I was trying extremely hard.
When we crossed the line, Tyus and Farrell and myself were taken down into the victory ceremony room, where we had makeup done and hair done and you know, general tidying up. And we were down there for some time. What happened was that the officials on the track, they gave me third position in the race. And the photo finish gave me fourth and Shevinska third. But that didn't happen until just before we were about to go out to the victory ceremony. So I was all lined up ready to go out and get a bronze medal. And the officials came in and basically told me to go. And Shevinska came in and she took the bronze medal. So it was a very disappointing start for me as a 17-year-old in my first Olympic final to have that happen to me. It was very confusing. I think I cried. I was only a kid. But in the long term, I think it made me very, very tough as a competitor. Lovely setting. Okay. Bye. Bye.